Catching bugs before they go to the hands of users is very essential. In today's video, I'm going to talk about pseudo-localization, which can help you to avoid future headaches when you are adding more language support to your application. Pseudo-localization is a method for testing your application's readiness for different languages. Let's say you have an application which currently only supports English as a localization, but in future you're planning to add more languages. As you have only one language support, it's easy to make mistakes such as adding hard-coded strings to the code itself. This can cause an unpleasant user experience and create more technical debt when you're adding more language support to your application. In simple words, pseudo-localization changes localizable strings in your app from this to this. Pay attention to the word localizable strings, which means that if you have any hard-coded strings, they won't be pseudo-localized. So pseudo-localization will help you to spot many UI issues, including right-to-left language support, layout problems, and hard-coded strings. Now we have a basic understanding of what pseudo-localization is. Let's take a look at my sample code where there are two text views, title and description. The title is set from main activities code. Before running the app, we need to enable developer options on emulator. I know it sounds really weird. If you are running the app on emulator, why developer options aren't enabled by default? Anyways, then we need to add this line to build.gradle file. Now let's run the app and see if there are any issues. App looks as it should be, but let's see how it will look like once I select pseudo-localization. Now we can see some issues. Since I had left a hard-coded string in my code, there is an issue here. Let's fix it and rerun the app. Alright, now I can test if my app is ready for the right-to-left or RTL localizations. This doesn't seem right. It looks like instead of using constraint start, I have used constraint left. After fixing this issue, the app UI seems as it should be. That's all for this video. If you want to read more about pseudo-localization, I will put some links in the description. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.